And when I'm puffing on a potent silent, but I stay strapped. Gave her wood, now she talking about family tree. You know it ain't that. Ain't got time for the bad bees, dog. I got money on mine. Watch my chain too long, have me nervous. I put money on your mind. The Cali be potent, that girl is a bogus. I can't risk my seed. My heart too low, took L's like fog. Big slime soon free. Had to drop cause the fans they keep asking. You drop trash, had the fans all laughing. Disappeared and I
What's up, what's up, what's up, my fellow 10 softers? Do you know what? I think I'm gonna, I like that one, 10 softers. If you haven't already, like and share, subscribe. I've seen that you guys have officially helped us get to 100 subscribers. I think we're at like 116 or something at the moment. So I just want to say a big thanks to everybody who has supported and got us to this stage. Via why I'm doing this video for you guys, because this one was requested. And I want you guys to throw in the hashtag 10 boys, because that's the name of our new clan, 10 boys. Show some love to the batch. And we obviously play Airsoft, so 10 soft is the hashtag as well. And yeah, Airsoft Special Ops. But anyways, let's get into it. So I did promise you guys, anyone who's been following since the beginning, this was a promise since the beginning of the channel. The first rifle I bought and showcased on the channel was the CM16. Put that to one side. And a lot of people had feedback for me, which was good and bad, and things I shouldn't have done to it, things I should have done. But I actually managed to get this bad boy fixed. So if you noticed, the CM16 is back, and I kind of just wanted to give you guys a look around it quickly and just show you guys what I've done and why I've done it and stuff like that. So I'm gonna start with the main body. I've kind of kept everything kind of like roughly the same. So things like my main sector, where my selector switch and stuff like that, have remained the same. So the upper and the lower is the same. If you can see, my lower exactly the same, my upper exactly the same. What I've done, however, two things, like my charging handle, for example, is I've changed the color. So it's currently that kind of like army style green, functional as well at the moment. So like you can hear, my handle just went off. I'll actually show you guys as well so you can see. Bear with me as well, because I'm working on angles for the channel, trying to work out what works so and what doesn't work, so you guys can see. So yeah, charging handle, functional. Have access to my hop up if needs be. Right at the top right there, it's a black one. I'm due to actually change that, so I'm going to upgrade that soon as well. So I'm going to bring you guys in with that. I'm also going to upgrade the barrel length. So I think currently it is somewhere around the 290 mark. I'm going to put it more closer to about 350, 360. I was looking at a barrel the other day, a tight bore barrel 363, just to utilize that space. It will mean that there will be a bit of stick out, but at the same time, it's kind of good just because I'm planning to put a silencer on the end of it. So I'm not too worried about that per se. I've obviously done the bullets. I think I showed you guys that in the last video update anyway, so I'm not going to talk too heavily on that bad boy. I put back the original sight, so I don't know if you guys can see what that looks like at the front right there. I just feel like it gives the gun a nice aesthetic, like say for example when aimed, trying to just get the camera to see, like you can see directly down the barrel, and it lands up nicely with the scope, because I've got a scope on there which has multifunctions. That's something I'll probably show you guys on the channel at a later date. But yeah, and it wasn't even expensive. I think the scope was about 25-30 quid, so maybe something for you guys who's looking for scopes out there for an affordable price. Do go and have a look, because it is worth the investment. I did leave the outer barrel same, GNG, slightly longer barrel. I just feel like it does the job. They say if it's not broken, don't fix it. I needed a grip, so I chucked a grip on it. I painted that one. I think I showed that in the last video, but I think it might be on my LT in the last video. So if you've seen the last video, then you'll see you've seen this grip before. Some people I know are gonna make fun of the end of my barrel. I've left it that way just because the tracer is gonna go in there. So in theory, there's no need for a muscle if the tracer doesn't come in time, because I've ordered it. If it doesn't come in time between now and my next game, what I'll probably do is I've got a couple muscles. I'll just put a muzzle on the end of it. I've also put things like a balancer on the front, because you're probably like, what the hell is that at the side of his gun? So I've put a balancer, which is normally what you do to like level out things like woodwork and bricks and stuff like that. But I just think it's useful because when, for example, holding the gun, say like I've got the gun held, obviously my angle will be a bit different to you guys, but I'm holding the gun in a straight direction, even though it looks across. I can level watch from the side angle here directly just from looking frontwards, because I'm this way, I'm backwards to the camera, so I'm facing that way backwards and my gun is pointing that way. It gives me the ability to, while holding the gun, find a balanced level. And I can see it from the front end of my gun, which is basically the outer barrel. And I've also got one at the back of the gun as well, right at the back where my charging handle is. And I've kind of just done so about that, guys. The stuff we go through for YouTube. The stuff we go through. And to be honest, it's not a bad thing. I just need to, my stabilizer broke. So in theory, I'm doing the most trying to shoot this video anyway, but I wanted to give you guys new content, so you guys better love me for this, because I'm having to battle with this broken stabilizer just to shoot a video. Hopefully it stays. So yeah, so what I've done is I've obviously put one on the back as well, just so that I have that same balance when aiming the gun. All I've got to do is kind of look over. Let me remove the mag, because the mag is what's causing me that drama. So yeah, it gives me the ability to look literally straight from the top and angle and say, oh, am I leveled, am I balanced, level yourself out. And also right at the back of the gun as well, it gives me the same ability to do the same thing and see if the gun is completely balanced or I'm leaning in forwards or backwards. So that's why I've done that. I also put like a clip attachment tool thing at the back. My boys are like, doesn't that get in your way? I'll show you what I'm talking about. So this thing, it's like a little tool that goes onto your rail, and it allows you to attach little clippy type style things on there, essentially. I put that on there because I like my rifle to kind of hang from my chest. It doesn't tend to get in the way, and even when aiming, if angled correct, like say it's angled like that, it's not gonna bother me. Say it's angled like that, it's not gonna bother me, because my eyes angle is here. So as long as I'm not looking directly through this, I'm all right. What else can I show you guys? I know some people is gonna say to me, why did I chuck the smaller stock back on it? But I done that on purpose. I just feel like when extended, it feels roughly about the extension level that I'd have a standard rifle stock anyway. And when smallened, when put back in, it makes your 30 rifle into a, how would you call it, like it makes your 30 rifle into like a SMG style sized gun. So imagine having a long ass barrel on an SMG style gun. It's just a perfect airsoft type gun. Plus I feel like it just kind of tucks the battery away. Like once the battery is connected, I don't ever really think about it. Whereas I feel like with the barreled type stocks, I've found in the past, because as I play the game, at times I'm adjusting. Sometimes I'm going for the fast shot, so I've got the more extended stock. Sometimes I'm going for more close up, so I'm lowering the stock into SMG mode. And it's like, what I found is with that movable circular stock, you're very concerned whether you're snagging the wires or stuff like that. So if you guys have any solutions out there how to get around that worry, then bring me in, because I wouldn't mind building a gun that has that longer circular stock, but I changed it for that reason, because like I said, with this stock, one thing I like is once your battery pack is connected and this is securely put on, as long as it's clipped on correct and none of your wires are clipped or anything like that, so you have to be careful with these kind of stocks. But once that's done, they're stress-free. Like, until you open it again, you really don't have to think about the stock. So I kind of like that, because you want to ensure that your trigger wiring and stuff like that, your battery wires are safe, and I feel like that stock has given you that. I've gone also for, what else have I done to this bad boy? I think I spoke about the what's it, sight glass before. Like, anyone who plays airsoft, especially outdoor skirmish, because I play a lot of outdoor skirmishes, more why I bought this one. As simple as it looks, this thing will save you so much money. I have friends who have probably lost about 6-7 different scopes just because somebody shot and it's broken their scope glass. So I will always advise, when trying to play skirmish outdoors, buy one of these bad boys, because they're cheap little things, but it just allows, and because they're so good, like, it's very rare, unless somebody shoots directly with a sniper, it's very rare that they crack on that shot. They tend to just deflect the bullet off. So great investment, and they're cheap. I paid probably like between £4 to £6 for this. Like, don't think I paid more than £6-7 at most. And even at £10, I think most of them I saw were about £10-12. So yeah, so that's that. And then I've changed my trigger also, because that was one thing that was bothering me. I always, from I've got this gun, I've always spoke about having a flat trigger. I just feel like it gives me a nice pullability. It works a certain way for me. I just like it. It works well. And then, like I said, the stock, you can get that quick release. What else has been done? Okay, the main problem, because you're probably going to be like, what the hell was wrong with the GNG in the first place? So I'm going to tell you a story, quick time, story time. So I had basically got the GNG, and like any airsofter, you get excited, right? I used it for probably about 4 or 5 games and saw the faults in it. I was like, oh, do you know what? I changed the grip as well. This is an LT35 grip. So that's one thing I should also add. The grip isn't from the GNG, it's why it looks different, but I done that on purpose, just because it's a quick change motor grip, which is why I did it. Like, if you look, all I've got to do is pull down a button, this opens and I can take out the motor, whereas my old one I had to pull out 2 screws and there was another clip to pull out before I had access to the motor. So it's kind of why I done that, because I just felt like it fits, it works, and this one is a bit more comfortable. So yeah, plus I feel like I've got more control over the gun when with this grip, whereas I feel like with the GNG one, it was quite slim and not much grip was on there. It was just pull them up all the way around. There's no grip pads like the grip pads you see here. But so what was wrong with it? So I had given, after the 6-7 games, you know, you use something, you start getting ideas. So I said to a tech, I found a tech, shouldn't have probably done it this way. I just went looking randomly. I should have got somebody recommended. Went, looked for a tech, spoke for a bit through Facebook, handed over numbers, whatnot. And then he said to me, meet me here with the money, drop off the gun. What you'll do is you pay half, he'll let the gun, pay the other half. I was like, all right, doesn't sound bad, let's go. Gave him the gun. All this guy was meant to do was do a spring change my trigger wiring to an electric trigger, and give the gun a once over, like a cleanup basically. By the time I got this gun back, the gun would not fire, the base plate kept on disconnecting itself from the nozzle. Like, I was just having bare problems. Like, the gearbox was so tight that it wouldn't turn. I was having so much issues. So the long and short of it was, I called him and I was like, fuck that, I need my money back, bruv, you fucked up my gun. And my gun was new, it was like only 6-7 games in once I gave it to you. So we went back and forth for a bit. You know how life goes, you get angry, words are discussed. We eventually got to a space where he decided that because Airsoft Tech King is about reputation and he fucked my gun up, he will basically pay for the gun to be fixed and buy me a new one. To be honest, I wasn't gonna have it any other way. I'm a man, don't touch my shit if you don't know what you're doing. But anyways, so he ended up paying me the money, buying a new CM16. I ended up selling the CM16 because by then I was so angry, I didn't want a replacement, I wanted to fix my current gun. So a couple months went by, I ended up getting the LT, which you guys should have seen on the channel by now. And that gun's done me amazing. Anyone who's looking for a cheap, affordable gun that goes the distance, easily upgradable, I will forever recommend it. Just like the CM16, it's just a nice place to start. It's affordable, it gets the job done, and the stick mags hold, I think it's like 100 bullets each, and they're so thin. So if you really wanted to, you could probably carry about 6 to 8 on your chest plate, and then maybe 2 or 3 around your belt. Like, you'd be strapped and ready to go 900, 1,000 EBs, give or take. Like, you don't even need a drum mag, and the drum mags are affordable as well. That's one thing I would say, they were like £70. But yeah, so I ended up, just because I was unsure all the damages that had happened to this gun, and I was still currently playing airsoft all the time, so I obviously needed a gun to play. So I bought the LT35 off my guy, ended up doing the work to it, whatnot, and then got to a place where I was like, do you know what, I need my CM16, because it was like I was doing things to the LT, but it wasn't my first love. Like, my CM16, I was just seeing it sit in the corner of the room. I was going to games, come back, and I knew what the gun was like. It's just such a good, it's a good build. As much as the body is polymer, as much as it isn't the most expensive gun, I just feel like it's a good all-rounder, especially if you do the right things to it, the right bucking, the right barrel, the right grip, the right motor. Like, if you do the right things to it, it's just a nice build, and it's light. Like, I love a Spectre Arms guns, but their guns are just way too heavy. Nobody wants to run around, unless you're carrying a real gun, you don't want to run around with something too heavy the whole day. You're just building arm muscle that you don't necessarily need. But yeah, unless you're a skinny nigga like me and you're trying to build some muscle, you know what I'm saying, then get Spectre Arms, card. Them bad boys are heavy. But yeah, like, I basically just wanted this back. I knew that this was the gun for me, and now that it's kind of been set up and fixed and whatnot, you know, and you kind of get confirmation of what you originally thought in the beginning. So I've still got a few things, like I said, that I'm currently doing to it. Like, I want to put a 363 barrel on it. I want to change the hop up to a metal hop up, because it's currently got a plastic / metal hop up. I just want a full metal hop up. Potentially change the bucking to a cold resistant bucking as well, just to up the performance a little bit. And then I think I would just probably chill, just maybe at most change the stock if this stock was started giving me problems. But apart from that, I think I'd be done, because happy with the scope, happy with the performance. The last couple things you hear me change, and maybe the motor, because I think my motor does somewhere around the 15 to 17k mark, but I've done some research that where I should more be is somewhere around the 30 to 40k mark. So I think that would be the last thing I'll do to this gun, and then kind of call it a day and be done here. But I did kind of want to show you guys it, because it was broken and now it's fixed. So by the time I had a look around the gun and stuff, bit by bit, I just took my time as I was upgrading the LT, because I had a gun to use when I was going to airsoft. I more used this as my project gun, and we got there in the end. Like, the barrel had some damage, so I ended up having to change out the barrel. The hop up had some damage, so I ended up having to change out the hop up. The bucking rubber, same thing. What else? The gearbox was fucked. I had to literally change the whole gearbox. I basically removed the shell, changed the shell to a quick change spring shell, and I kept the spring was all right. Spring guide I upgraded, the trigger wiring I upgraded because that was damaged, like it had some shorts in it. And then yeah, literally just put it back in with the GNG motor, changed the grip, and then I noticed it was shooting. I literally just opened the gun one more time, give it a once over, checked the battery, started using an 11.1.
Meditate on past actions, ish I had to do. If we unified, we overcome slavery. Many think it, I just say it, call it bravery. Young, progressive and black, you know they hate to see. Independent, I don't care what labels could pay a G. So much leng past my lungs, feeling like a fiend. When you stuck up in the trench, self-meds, how you just dream. I strive for perfection. Private company feeding us GMO foods, they wanting us trapped. My young boy just came home for a booting, that young nigga tapped. Can't be slipping when I'm puffing on a potent silent, but I stay strapped. Gave her wood, now she talking about family tree, you know it ain't that. Ain't got time for the bad bees, dog, I got money on mine.
Watch my chain too long, have me nervous. I put money on your mind. The Cali be potent, that girl is a bogus. I can't risk my seed. My heart too low, took L's like fog. Big slime soon free. Had to drop cause the fans they keep asking. You drop trash, had the fans all laughing. Disappeared and I read you. Meditate on past actions. Ish I had to do.
So.